Thank you, sir, for giving me the opportunity. Honorable Chairperson.
Come on. Go this side.
Honorable Chairperson.
Yes, sir.
I would like to thank you for.
YSR Congress Party.
Yes, sir.
After that, Shivasena.
Give me an opportunity to put forth our party YSRCP views on crop losses. Chairman, sir, in India, a majority of our population is still dependent on agriculture. There is a, number one, inappropriate time to discuss the issue concerned our farmers. Sir, in India, a large number of farmers undertake subsistence agriculture for survival. Farming is also undertaken on loans, which deals to debt trap most of the time. In the light, the worst adversity that farmers could face is crop loss. Sir, such crop loss make survival of farmers a concern, wherein there have been many instances of farmers committing suicide due to loss of crops. The situation for landless and tenant farmers is much more worse. Chairman, sir, before entering into the nuances of this issue, I would like to congratulate our Honorable CM Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu for launching the YSR Raitu Bharosa PM Kisan scheme, through which landless and tenant farmers are said to get monetary support from the government in our state. The scheme is a scheme where maximum support is offered to farmers out of all 29 states of India. Under this scheme, sir, 51 lakhs farmers, which also include more than 3 lakhs tenant farmers from SC, ST, PC communities, will each receive 13,500 per annum as farm investment support. A conscious effort has been made to include tenant and landless farmers as they stand excluded from the vision of PM Kisan scheme. Speaker, sir, such a move is bound to stoke up positive sentiments amongst landless and tenant farmers that the government cares for them and it is concerned about the difficulties faced by them to undertake a hard-working task like agriculture and crop cultivation. The support provided by the YSR Raitu Bharosa scheme is bound to help farmers hide crop losses and also help invest in quality farming techniques that can prevent crop losses to begin with. Chairman, sir, the reason for crop losses in India have been studied by different organizations. The foremost reason for the crop losses is found to be infestation by pests, weeds, and due to climatic conditions like cyclones and untimely rain. ICR scientists estimated that about 30 to 35% of the annual crop in India gets wasted because of pests. Chairman, sir, the recent infestation by farm armyworm is fresh in our memory, where it impacted almost 10 Indian states. In a country where farmers do not get remunerative returns, even healthy produce, crop losses due to such avoidable reasons are unforgivable. The reason for high prevalence of such losses are because pesticides may be unaffordable to some farmers. Farmers may thus use other makeshift method to protect crop from pests, which is low on effectiveness. In the light, the government support through schemes like Raitu YSR Raitu Bharosa scheme will help farmers invest good quality pesticides. Quality of pesticides is lacking. At the present, quality control regime for pesticides is lacking. In this light, the proposed Pesticides Management Bill 2019 can be game-changed to ensure accountability in the effectiveness aspects of pesticides. Pests become resistant to pesticides due to the unscientific use of pesticides by farmers due to poor awareness. The extension program of government and the newly proposed bill needs to spread awareness about scientific usage amongst farmers, especially the less empowered ones. Poor focus on international best practices and research and development on crop protection means. There are good emerging trends and solutions for sustainable crop protection, which include crop protection, chemical agronomy, fertigation, sea treatment and biotechnology development, which needs to be encouraged. Seeds of poor quality have no resilience against damage, which is serious cause of concern. Chairman sir, almost 60% Indian agriculture is rain fed, thus depend on vagaries of monsoon for its success. In this light, another major reason for crop losses in the impact of drought. Our state of Andhra Pradesh, after facing such situations, were beyond our control, especially in districts such as Anantapur, Kadapa, Chittoor, and Kurnool. In these cases, our dedicated efforts should go into crop diversification to grow less water-intensive crops. And in this region, the successful implementation and the drought mitigation program, there is a need to revoke our MSP policy, which does not intensifies farmers to have a healthy cropping pattern. In addition to that, more often the MSP announced would be higher, but there won't be any procurement happening at the rate of the government, and the government should actively procure the crop from the farmers at MSP rate. In coastal states such as Andhra Pradesh, cyclone are looming threat for crops. The cyclone Pethai in 2019 led to the damage of over 10 lakh hectares of crop, according to preliminary estimates. Such vagaries of weather conditions are bound to impact Indian agriculture due to its precious nature. Sir, with the climate change breathing down our necks, such natural calamities and vagaries are bound to rise. Thus, we need to consider preventive and damage control mechanism such more seriously. Sir, lastly, post-harvesting crop losses also damaged our attention. Transport system for farmers to take the crop too far of markets is also cause of concern. Sir, it become vital for us as a parliamentarian to deliberate our responsibility towards the annadata and the steps that can be taken to ameliorate their conditions. Sir, the PM Fasal Bima Yojana is a significant help for farmers to face the consequences and tide over the losses that come with crop damages. The government should ensure its effectiveness, effective implementation, and redress grievances in mission mode to enhance effectiveness. Social audits of the scheme by its beneficiaries can be conducted to incorporate necessary changes. Firstly, sir, India should focus on R&D to tackle agriculture specific challenges of climate changes. This should include research in quality of seed, pesticides, enhancing shelf life of crops, and ensuring these technologies travel from lab to lab without burdening farmers. Second point, Speaker sir, we have to map the cropping pattern in incentivize the shift wherever necessary. The policy of farm loan waivers should be seriously relooked and reworked upon. And it does not seem to tackle core problem of agriculture and crop losses. Rather, more investment in efficient infrastructure for agriculture supply chain, including storage, transport, etc. Sir, this discussion that we are having is not new. We all know the reasons for crop loss and have a general idea about what needs to be done and what should be our priority. It is high time that we are aligned together and show a dedicated political will to help our Raitu, who are new contemplating suicide, or running from pillar to post for his voice to be heard. Let us pledge to change the situation of agriculture in India. As Swaminathan once said, if agriculture goes wrong, nothing else will have a chance to go right in the country. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Next speaker, Sri Vinayak Rao Ji.